our knowledge of space is increasing dramatically, to the point where we can not only predict what's happening in the outer limits, but actually change it.
The DART mission, it stands for the Double Asteroid Redirection Test. We are the first mission that is actually going to go out there and try to figure out how do you stop an asteroid. We're going to launch the spacecraft, which will travel 10 months in space and then slam into an asteroid called Dimorphos to release about 9 kilotons of energy to see if we can actually change its orbit. DART does not hit an asteroid that's actually coming towards Earth, but we are the first test of that technique of kinetic impact, and we are the first planetary defense mission.
In my research, I study extrasolar planets. These are planets outside of our solar system orbiting distant stars. So we basically use spectroscopy. Essentially how the technique works is a planet will pass in front of a star and some of the light from the star will pass through the atmosphere and leave a spectral fingerprint. So atoms and molecules high in the atmosphere of a planet will absorb at very specific colors. But we basically want to find which planets could be habitable for sort of an Earth 2.0 with a sort of similar characteristics as Earth. And life that's much like our own, looking at their atmospheres, picking up things like oxygen in the atmosphere would be a pretty solid biomarker signature.
Asteroids have been hitting Earth for a long period of time. You know, in 2013, for example, in Chelyabinsk, Russia, there was one big asteroid that came in and created a giant blast that actually, you know, hospitalized about 1,000 people. The threat is real. In addition to that, we're flying a lot of other things for NASA. The next C, ion thruster, which is an ion grid engine, as well as new types of solar arrays. Our number one technology that we're carrying is smart navigation. That's what actually allows us to hit this asteroid that's millions of miles away.
When I started doing this sort of research, there was only a handful of known exoplanets, but I think the last count was over 4,000. So it's really thrilling to sort of push the field forward. And being a Bloomberg Distinguished Professor has been pretty transformative, especially because they were designed from the beginning to be cross-disciplinary.
The Johns Hopkins Applied Physics Laboratory and Johns Hopkins University in particular is really well qualified to do this because we combine both the expertise in sciences and also engineering. And APL prides itself on critical contributions to critical challenges.
This is a moment in time when a new understanding of space is within reach, and Johns Hopkins is leading the way.